Today on the channel, Black Panther, Attuma Build a Figure series, Hatute Zeraze on Way I Got It Figured.
The way I got it figured.
Hello out there, Toyland. Way I Got It Figured back with another Marvel Legends review. This time, Marvel Legends series, Black Panther, Hatute Zeraze, from the Attuma Build-A-Figure wave, with the release of Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. I wanted to do something with, with the Black Panther. And I know I'd already done the two Black Panther reviews, but I had these Hatute Zeraze figures waiting in the wings to open them, and I wanna talk about them and do a review. So that's what we're gonna do. Also, we've got T'Challa here on standby. We're gonna take him out for now. So here's the packaging, Hatute Zeraze. And his package, very nice pose artwork. Here's the comic art, the back of the box with the part that he comes with, which is one of Attuma's legs, and all the weapons, which is a masterclass in how they part out these waves for accessories. You know, one of the minor complaints that I had with the Black Panther figure, which is, a pretty excellent figure, is that he only comes with some hands. So, I guess so that they could come with everything they needed, he only had to come with hands. Then on the side, you got your Build-A-Figure of Attuma, and it comes with the right leg, number 4. Boom, there you go. All right, so we're gonna get Hatute Zeraze out. I do have two of these, so I'm gonna get two of them out. And I'll go over some facts about the character as well as the figures. All right, let's do it. All right, so here we have the Hatute Zeraze out of the package with his weapons and extra hands and Attuma Build-A-Figure part arrayed. So, like I said, it's the right leg of Attuma. I'm not going to be building this figure. I actually donated the other leg to Phil from Way I Got It Figured. I mean, excuse me, from Crossfire Collectibles. And the part that T'Challa came with, I also gave him that so he could do his MCU Attuma. So, yeah, it's a leg. There you go. Of course, he comes with this energy weapon rifle. Looks like an energy type of pistol. And your four hands, two gun wielding hands. Two clawed hands. And then, of course, he has the fists arrayed. Oh, I got these figures from Hasbro Pulse. So, all three of the figures I got them from Hasbro Pulse, Black Panther and the Hatute Zeraze. Now, this is the, this one, I don't know, his leg's like a little warped, which sometimes you get with Marvel Legends figures. And he has pins. Maybe somebody can tell me. I didn't do a lot of research on the history of this mold. I assumed that it was a repaint of some kind, but I don't remember them doing a Black Panther with these elements. So in the comic books, the Hatute Zerazes wore white versions of the 1998 version of Black Panther's costume, which was, which had these, obviously the costume was black. These were gold instead of silver here. And I think they had, he had like something over here, like almost like a little belt or something, but that's not there. Head's probably a little different. And the story on the Hatute Zeraze is the Hatute Zeraze roughly translates to dogs of war. They are the Wakandan secret police, and they handle, you know, all kinds of black ops or whatever for Wakanda. They were led by a man called Hunter, who was also known as the White Wolf, who wore a white version of the Black Panther costume that I, as I just described it there. And T'Challa exiled the Hatute Zeraze and their leader, White Wolf, from Wakanda for their kind of extreme way of doing things. But they still remain loyal soldiers of Wakanda, even though they were cast out. I bought two of these because sort of my rule, and it's a relatively new rule, is if I'm going to army build, I generally only buy two. I only want to, you know, I don't need 29 Hatute Zerazes. That's fine if that's what you want to do, but, you know, for me, 6-inch figures take up a lot of space, and the more you have of duplicates, the more it's just sort of clogging up your space. So for me, two is the number. I do reserve the right to change it, or, you know, in certain circumstances, but generally that's about the most I'm gonna do. So Hatute Zeraze has the standard Marvel Legends articulation. It's pretty poseable, can kick pretty high. Kick back not as far, but good enough. Ample head tilt up and down. Pretty poseable figure. He almost has like this weird semi butterfly joint, which is definitely gonna make me look more into this mold. I would certainly like a Black Panther based off of the 90s Black Panther, which, you know, I thought they would have done. I thought they actually would have done for the 20th anniversary of Marvel Legends, which I do have that figure, the Toy Biz version. So they didn't, but, you know, but if they didn't, then I can almost see them doing a Black Panther in this way if they have it, right? So, it's a very, very cool figure for an army builder. I'm pretty pleased. So I'm going to bring in his twin brother, who already sort of had armed up. And there you go. This is a little rifle. So I guess we'll make this guy lefty. And give him a pistol. Bada bing. There you go. So if you want to know where the Hatute Zeraze come from, want to look up some Black Panther comic books, their first appearance was in Black Panther Volume 3, Number 4, which was a part of the Marvel Knights imprint. So back in the 90s, they did the Marvel Knights thing, and I think it was like Daredevil, Black Panther, Black Widow. It was like four titles, and Daredevil which was done by Kevin Smith and Joe Quesada. Black Panther was written by Christopher Priest and drawn by Mark Teixeira. And definitely he was the one who first drew these guys. And there were some really, really cool stories. It was almost like a renaissance. It was right when Joe Quesada had taken over as editor-in-chief of Marvel, and he was doing big things. So this is one of the cooler things that came out of all of that. And that whole run where Black Panther was, revealed to be some almost like a spy. He joined the Avengers to keep an eye on the Avengers, for the safety of Wakanda and all that kind of stuff. So there you go. All right, so so let's do. All right, so final thoughts. Black Panther series, Hatute Zeraze, I'm going to give them an 8. Black Panther, Hatute Zeraze, I'm going to give them an 8 out of 10. They're definitely reprints of some kind. I'm sure these molds have been used before. I'm just not 100% sure of where. I guess in the information section, I'll put that information. But, because they're reprints, I can't reuse. I can't give them a 10. And they're army builders. I probably generally wouldn't give them a 10 anyway. Although I have given army builders a 10. In the past, for G.I. Joe Classified, because those figures were just awesome. These are more standard. So, 8 out of 10, not bad. All right, guys. I do have more Marvel Legends content. I'm actually kind of jumping all over the place, really. These figures are more recent than some other figures that I have, so I will be getting to those shortly. If you like the content, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I do respond to all my comments, good, bad, indifferent. I'm always looking to improve my videos as well. So, I'm not gonna take it badly. Please, everybody stay safe. And I do want to thank you for watching the video, and I will see you next time.